Good morning children, I'm Purnima and I welcome you all to my this channel and I'm going to teach you Princess September. In fact children, I've already taught you and we are going to revise this nice lesson. Okay, wonderful story of Princess September written by Somerset Maugham. So who is the writer here? Somerset Maugham is the name of the writer here. Now let me tell you about the background of the lesson. The king and queen of Siam. So the king was from which place? He was from Siam. Had many daughters. The king and queen, they had many daughters. In order to avoid confusion, the king called the princess by the name of the month. So now children, they were having 12 to 13 daughters. So in order to avoid confusion, the king called the princess by the name of the month like January, February, March, etc. So the daughters' names were kept on the name of the month. The last daughter was named September. So what was the name of the last daughter? It was September. Her name was kept September. The king of Siam had a peculiar habit. Instead of accepting birthday gift, he used to give everyone gift. Now children, one more peculiar habit the king of Siam had on his birthday, instead of taking the gift, instead of accepting the gift from other, what he used to do? He used to give gift to the other people. So again, this was his one of the most peculiar habit, because generally what happened in this generally what happened children, the people give the gift, okay, the people, the king of Siam had a peculiar habit, instead of accepting birthday gift, he used to give everyone gift. One year on his birthday, he gave each one of the princes a green parrot in a golden cage. So what happened children, one year on his birthday, he gave each one of the princes a green parrot in a golden cage. So what he had done, he gave each one of the princes a green parrot in a golden cage. Then so children, that beautiful parrots were given to their daughters. Okay, the parrots were very beautiful green color parrots in a golden cage. The princess taught the bird to say, "God save the king." Some of the parents would say, "Pretty Polly," in 7 oriental languages. Now children, the princess taught their parrots, okay, what did the parrots were taught? The parrots were taught to say, "God save the king." And some of the parrots would say, "Pretty Polly," in 7 oriental languages. This was taught to them in 7 oriental languages. Now children, one day when princess saw the cage, she saw her parrot was dead and she burst into tears because she used to love her parrot very much. She started crying. The queen called her crying nonsense. Now children, the queen did not like that her daughter was crying very badly. So she told that the queen called her crying nonsense and put her to bed without any supper. And children, she went to the bed without any food. Princess September was woken up by the song of a little bird. Suddenly children, she went without taking a food. She was very upset. She was very sad because her favorite, the most loved parrot, it was dead. Now children, Princess September was woken up by the song of the little bird. He flew into her room and sang beautifully. Now children, he flew into the room of the parrot, one of the birds. It came into her room and it was singing in a very beautiful manner. Princess September forgot crying. She agreed to have it in place of her dead parrot. And children, Princess September, when she saw that beautiful bird, it was singing, she forgot for some time about her dead parrot. And what she wanted to have, she wanted to have that bird. She agreed to have it in place of her dead parrot. Now she decided dead. Okay, if her parrot is dead, let it be dead. Okay. Though she was very sad, but then she decided she will keep that bird instead of that parrot. Now, the king had got tired of hearing those parrots say pretty Polly. Okay, now children, finally children, what was decided? The princess will keep that beautiful bird, okay, in her palace. When the princess awoke the next day, the little songbird was still there and he said good morning. Now children, when the princess woke next day, she had seen that little songbird was still there, and this time the songbird said to her good morning. So what did the bird said to her in the morning? Good morning. He ate rice out of her hand. Now children, the bird was very fond of the princess. She gave him rice to eat and he ate the rice from the princess' hand. Now everybody was surprised with that bonding between the prince and that bird, little bird. Okay, everybody was surprised to see that. Princess September decided to show her bird to her 8 sister. Now Princess September, even she was happy the bird was behaving. Okay, the bird was eating with her hand. The bird used to tell her good morning in the morning. Okay, and she was not flying away. She was remaining with, she remained with her for hours. So she was very happy and she decided to show that bird to the, she decided to show that bird to the to her 8 sister. Okay, he flew into her room and sang beautifully. Princess September forgot crying. Now children, that bird, children, he flew into her room and sang beautifully. Princess September forgot crying. She agreed to have it in the place of her dead parent. Now what happened? Princess September, she agreed to have her that bird in place of her dead parent. So children, it was decided now that bird will be permanently be kept with the Princess September palace. The parrot could only say, God save the king. The king and the queen were also surprised and delighted to hear the bird song. Now children, next day she showed the bird to her parents also. The king was tired of hearing all the parrots saying God save the king and pretty Polly. So when they heard the beautiful song from the bird, so they were very happy. Okay, and but children, the 8 princes, they were not happy. They were worried that the bird has impressed the king also. And children, all the 8 princes were worried now. The parents also looked sad. Only Princess September ran in the places singing like a lark. Okay, lark is a beautiful word. Now children, that Princess September, what happened? Even all the, that means her sister, they were worried. They were not happy to see that beautiful bird singing nicely. They were more worried when the king was happy. And children, they were sad. Even their parents had become sad. Only a happiest person was the Princess September, who was running in a place singing like a lark. She was very happy because the bird has made her very happy. The beautiful bird was singing. She was wishing her good morning. She was taking from her hand. She was taking, it was taking the food also to eat. Well, the jealous sister took a nasty decision. They pointed out to their youngest sister that she should put her bird into a cage lest he should fly away for good. Now children, the sister were very much jealous and they thought that how to make her younger sister sad. Even the bird they wanted to make sad. If the bird will sad, she will not sing in a very nice beautiful manner and then everything will be turned against her sister. So she, their sister, they had given her a suggestion. And what suggestion they had given to her? They had given to her the suggestion that why don't you put this beautiful bird in the cage. They have told her that why don't you put this beautiful bird in the cage. Well, so they told her that if you will not keep that beautiful bird in the cage, it would fly away. It would fly away for good. The little bird came late that evening. September's worry was about his safety from hawks and the hunter's trap. Now children, that day children, the bird came very late. The bird came very, very late. And Princess September was very much worried. She was thinking if some hawk must have attacked to her, or she must have trapped in some hunter's trap. So as he came, she pushed him into a cage and shut the door. And children, the moment the bird had arrived, though she was keen for the safety of the bird, she did not want to hurt the bird, but then anyway she had kept the bird in the cage. The moment the bird has came it came to her room, what happened? September was so much worried that as he came, she pushed him into a cage and shut the door. She finally, what happened, she had pushed him inside the cage and she had shut the door. The bird was taken aback. Now children, the bird was very much surprised. He did not expected her this thing from Princess September, because till now children, the bird was free in her room. He was singing, he was eating with her hand. Okay, he was, that bird was very much free. The bird was free, and children, what was happening? The bird was flying everywhere freely. He was singing, he was eating from her hand. So even the bird did not expect this thing, that she will be pushing him into the cage suddenly, and she will be making him the prisoner. She will be shutting the door of the cage. So the bird was taken aback. He hoped that he would be set free in the morning, but he cried in vain for liberty. Now children, in the morning also, he thought she would make him free in the morning. Okay, he waited for the morning, but she did not do that. But he cried in vain for liberty. Now children, what is the meaning of liberty? Liberty means freedom. But the bird cried. Okay, he cried, but it was, why he cried? He wanted to have his freedom back, and he cried, but what happened? He cried in vain. It was useless. As a result, he lost his singing talent. As a result, what happened? He lost his singing talent. He refused to eat anything. And children, he did not eat anything from the hands of Princess September. He was very much sad. So children, what happened? The jealous sister took a nasty decision, and what decision they had taken? The parrot, that he told their advice, the sister, that he will be locked inside the cage. Okay, otherwise he would fly away. So this they were telling because they were jealous from their sister. The little bird came late evening, and princess sister was so much worried. She thought that if some hawk must have attacked him, or he must have trapped, some hunter must have trapped him. So she quickly pushed him into the golden cage and she locked the cage. Now the bird was taken aback. He thought that in the morning he would be set free, but he cried in vain for liberty. As a result, children, what happened? He became so sad that he forgot to sing. He was so sad that he did not sing at all. He refused to eat anything. He also refused to eat anything that was given to him. So children, the bird did not eat anything. It was very sad. In fact, she was starving for her liberty. Okay, she wanted to be free. She did not like, for the first time she was locked in the cage. Well, the next day September found the bird lying with his eyes closed. Okay, and it did not even eat anything. So he looked as if he were dead. Now children, the world was lying in such a way that everybody thought that it is dead. She agreed to let him leave the golden cage, and the bird promised to return to her every day and sing to her. Now children, what happened? The bird promised to return to her every day and sing to her. Now children, seeing his condition, since the princess used to love him, even she became very sad. So she asked him what to do. She did not want to lose him. So she agreed to let him. So he told that you make me free. But she told, kept a condition for it. She told him, if you will come every day in my palace and if you will sing, I will let you free. Her sister made fun of her. They said he would never return. Now children, the sister, they were very jealous, and they told that he will never return back. But he did at last, and he sat on September's shoulder and ate out of his hand. But children, the bird was very faithful. The bird was very loyal to Princess September. He sat on September's shoulder and ate out of his hand. He sat on the shoulder and he ate out of her hand and sang her the beautiful song he had learned. And children, he sang the beautiful song which he had learned. September kept her window open all that day and night for the bird to fly in and out. So what happened, children? September, she kept her window open all the day and night for the bird to fly in and out. So she flew in and out. She kept her window open. Fresh air from the open window made the princess extremely beautiful. She was now children, now the fresh air, it started coming from her window. Only her window was open due to the bird. Otherwise, rest of the sister, they have closed their window. So fresh air made her, the princess, extremely beautiful. She was married to the king of Cambodia. Finally, children, that princess, she was married to the king of Cambodia. But her sister, who kept the window shut, grew ugly as well as unpleasant. Now children, this was the case of Princess September, but other princes who used to close the window with their good thought, they became ugly, but they became very unpleasant. So they were married away with the king's minister. So children, finally what happened? They were married with the king's minister. Now children, with this I have completed the background of the story, and now I will be doing the explanation of the story of Princess September. So it is chapter number 5, okay, page number 34. Princess September, like each one of her numerous sister, numerous means many sister, numerous means many sisters, received the gift of a parrot in a golden cage on her father's birthday. And children, she had received, you can see in the picture also, the king is presenting Princess September a beautiful green colored parrot in a golden cage. So this was the gift of her father's side. Instead of taking the gift in his birthday, what he is doing, he is giving the gift to the sister. The parrot dies, and by chance a singing bird comes in its palace. Unfortunately, I told you in the back, while telling the background of the story, the parrot dies, and the princess show off her pet to the sister, who advise her to put in a cage. The king and the queen of Siam had many daughters, and the queen said that it confused her to have to remember so many names. Now children, the king and the queen of Siam, now I'm starting the lesson. Siam, children, in the old time it was told to Thailand. So she was the princess from Thailand. So the king and queen of Siam had many daughters. So you can see in the picture, so many daughters, at least 9 to 10 daughters they were having. Okay, and the queen said that it is confused her to have to remember so many names. So children, the queen was worried. She is telling she had so many daughters, and it will be very confusing to remember the name. So the king decided, one day the king decided to call them January, February, March. Oh. though of course in Siamese, not children, in the language of Thailand, okay, not in English. What name he had kept? January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September. Okay. Till he came to the youngest, whom he called September. And children, the youngest daughter was given the name September. The king of Siam had a peculiar habit. Instead of receiving gifts on his birthday, he gave them. Now children, the king of Siam, I told you, he had a particular peculiar habit. Instead of taking the gift, he used to give the gift on his birthday. One year on his birthday, not having anything else handy, he gave each of his daughters a green parrot in a golden cage. So what happened, children? One day what happened? He gave each of his daughters a green parrot in a golden cage. So he gave his daughters a green color parrot in a golden cage. The princess was very proud of their parrots, and they spent an hour every day in teaching them to talk. Now children, all the princes, they liked the gift very much. They were very much interested in teaching their parrots. And what did they taught? They taught their parrots to say, God save the king. So what did they taught their parrots? They taught their parrots to say, God save the king. And some of them could say Pretty Polly in no less than 7 oriental language. And children, some of the parrots, they could say Pretty Polly in 7 of the oriental language. And children, oriental, you can see the meaning is written in the gloss of the book. Oriental is the eastern, the language of the eastern world. Okay, the countries which are there in the far east. So in their language, these daughters, they have taught their bird to say, taught them to say, Pretty Polly and God save the king. Now, but one day when Princess September went to say good morning to her parrot, she found it lying dead at the bottom of its golden cage. Now children, in the morning, princess used to go to her parrot to say good morning. And one day when she went to the parrot, what did she see? She had seen that her parrot was lying dead at the bottom of the golden cage. She burst into a flood of tears. She was shocked. She was in great sorrow, in a deep sorrow. And then she burst into tears. She started crying and tears came from her eyes. Flood of tears came from her eyes, and nothing that her maid of honor could say comforted her. Children, maid of honor were the maid of the princess. They tried to comfort her, but they were not able to say anything. Any word did not make the Princess September to get in a comfortable, to get comforted. She cried so much that the maids of honor, not knowing what to do, told the queen, and the queen said it was stuff and nonsense and the child had better go to bed without any supper. So children, when the maid of honor told about the September, about the youngest daughter September to the queen, she told me it is a nonsense that she is not having anything to eat. It is useless to cry for that bird. She should have supper, and if she is not having, let her go to bed. Now children, by saying this, the queen did not come to the princess for her comfort, to give her comfort. Now Princess September left alone, as the queen, the maid of honor, wanted to go to a party. So they took permission from the queen, and in this way children, Princess September was left alone all by herself. And while she lay in her bed crying, still, even though she left rather hungry. Now children, she started crying. Okay, she was remembering her parrot and she was crying. At the same time, children, she felt hungry, but nobody was there to give her food. Even the mother was not there with her, the maid of honor. She had gone to the party to enjoy the party. So she was left alone. Nobody was there to give her food. She was left all by herself. And while she lay in her bed, crying, still, even though she felt rather hungry, she saw a little bird hop into her room. Suddenly, what happened, children? She saw a small little bird. It hopped into her room. She wiped her tears and sat up. Now, children, she wiped her tear and sat up. Then the little bird began to sing, and he sang a beautiful song all about the lake in the king's garden. Now, children, that beautiful bird, it started singing. And what it sang a beautiful song all about the lake in the king's garden. Children, it started singing a song related with a lake. You know what is a lake? Okay, water body. That was there in the king's garden. And the willow tree that looked at themselves in the still water. And children, what else she sang about? She sang about the willow tree. Okay, the beautiful willow tree that looked at themselves in the still water. Children, the reflection of the willow tree was falling on the water of the lake, and that tree were looking their reflection and they were singing about themselves. Then children, what other thing, children? And the goldfish that glided in and out of the branches that were reflected in it. And children, the other beautiful things that the bird sang was the reflection of the tree. Even the branches and the branches reflection were there in the water. And children, the goldfish inside the water, they were crossing, they were coming through the branches reflection of the tree which was seen in the water. When he had finished, the princess was not crying anymore, and she quite forgot that she had no supper. So children, when he had finished singing, the princess was so happy that she did not cry anymore. And she quite forgot that she had no supper. Now children, she also forgot that she had not eaten her food. That was a very nice song, she said. Now children, she complimented the bird by saying that that was a very nice song. The little bird gave her a bow. The little bird was so happy that it bow in front of September. Would you care to have me in place of your parrot? Now children, it seems that the bird knew everything about her parrot, and the bird offered herself that now you have lost your parrot, so would you like to keep me instead of in place of your parrot? And the little bird said, it is true that I'm not so pretty to look at, but on the other hand I have a much better voice. Now children, at the same time, what did the bird told? He is telling, I am not as beautiful as that parrot which you were having, that beautiful green color parrot. But then I have got a good voice and I can sing a beautiful song to make you happy. Princess September clapped her hand with delight, and then the little bird hopped onto the end of her bed and sang her to sleep. Now children, when Princess September heard this, she was very happy. She was extremely happy and she clapped. She was so happy that she clapped, and the little bird hopped to the end of her bed and it started singing. It sang so sweetly that Princess September, it slept. The maid of honor brought in her breakfast and he ate rice out of her. So children, when she awoke next day, the little bird was still there. And as she opened her eyes, he said, good morning. The maids of honor brought in her breakfast. So when she awoke next day, the little bird was still there. And as she opened her eyes, he said, good morning. The maids of honor brought in her breakfast. And he ate rice out of her. So children, when she awoke, when the princess awoke next morning, the little bird was still there. Okay, and when the princess opened her eyes, the bird told her good morning. He ate rice out of her hand and he had his bath in her saucer. He began to sing again so beautifully that the maid of honor were quite surprised, for they had never heard anything like it. So children, everybody was very much surprised. They were very happy at how beautiful this bird is singing. Okay, And children, Princess September, since the bird was very friendly and she requested, did you remember that I told you that the bird was requesting Princess September to keep her in place of her parrot? So she was feeling very proud and happy. Okay, so children, with this I end my video here. Okay, and tomorrow we will do the rest of the I will tell you the rest of the story in my next video. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.